my novel, The Cove, Laurel is the central character, and she is a woman who, in a sense, has been buried alive. It's almost as if she's a ghost, and she starts to feel that way. She's almost afraid to look in a mirror because she's afraid she will not see any reflection. And in the novel, a young man, rather mysterious young man coming into the valley, gives her a chance for the first time in her life to feel not only alive, but as she finds out, to understand what happiness actually is. It's something she's never experienced. So she's a woman of great sensitivity who has been ostracized by the community, but a woman of great depths. And in the novel, I hope the reader comes to care about her and to appreciate her life, as tragic as it begins. I don't want to lose half of possible characters by just writing about men. So I want to write about women as well. It seems to me that what I love about novels is the freedom that we can transcend ourselves through empathy. And many of the writers that I admire most are able to do this. Annie Proulx, the American Western writer, writes primarily about men, even though she's a woman. And I think that kind of freedom is one of the glorious things of literature. I've always been fascinated with what sometimes lies beneath water, beneath land, what has happened in the past, and those mysteries I'm very drawn to, particularly in my writing, but also in life. That I see my work very often as a kind of excavation, an unearthing of things that have been hidden, things that have been mysterious mysteries, and I hope that the reader is as intrigued as I am. As much as I am a Southerner, and as much as I love William Faulkner, if I had to pick one book, I would pick Herman Melville's Moby Dick. That is the book that is my all-time favorite American novel. I go back and read it probably every 2 years, and it's a big book, but it's a magnificent book, and every time I read it, I find so much more in it.